nighttime in the big city. A bus driver talks to his only passenger. A sailor on shore leave plays Egyptian rat screw with a fallen priest. It's Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Welcome to Theme Time Radio Hour. We've got kind of a special program for you tonight. It's our first annual Theme Time Radio Hour countdown show, where we count down the top 10 songs as determined by you, the listener.
The Big Top 10 is here again, so listen close to the Big Top 10, because we're about to spin the top 10 tunes you pick to win. The Big Top 10 will bring to you the tunes you like, whether old or new. We know you'll like the show, so lend an ear, cause here we go.
All right then, let's get right to it. We'll start out at number 10. And number 10 is The Ten Commandments of Man by Cecil Campbell, better known as Prince Buster.
The Ten Commandments of Man, given to all man through the inspiration of I, Prince Buster.
This song was a huge hit in Jamaica and also had some chart action in the United States. Prince Buster was the first Jamaican to have a top 20 hit. This is the Ten Commandments of Man given to women through the inspiration of I, Prince Buster.
One, thou shalt have no other man but me. Two, thou shalt not encourage no man to make love to you, neither kiss nor caress you, for I'm your man, a very jealous man, and is ready to lay low any other man that may intrude in our love. Three, remember to kiss and caress me, honor and obey me in my every woman fancy, 7 days a week and twice on Sundays, cause of no time will I ever be tired of IT hit.
Thank you. That was the Ten Commandments of Man. A slightly different Ten Commandments than they teach in Sunday school, but important knowledge nonetheless. Coming in at number 9. It's our old friend Sonny Boy Williamson. He's got a song about a cold snap called Nine Below Zero, recorded for the Chess label. A cold snap is a geological term for a period of intensely cold and dry weather, often occurring during an ice age. It might also be called a blackberry winter or a dogwood winter. I think Sonny Boy Williamson's Nine Below Zero certainly qualifies.
She waited till they got 9 below 0 and put me down for another man. I'll give her all my money, all of my loving and everything. All of my money, all of my loving and everything. It done got 9 below 0 and she done put me down for another man.
Ain't that a pity? It's 9 below 0 and I give her all my money and she put me down for another man. Sonny Boy Williamson, 9 below 0 on the Theme Time Radio Hour Countdown Show.
Countdown time!
Coming in at number 8 is Overton Vertus Wright. 8 Men, 4 Women. O.V. Wright started off like many of his compatriots as a gospel singer, singing for the Sunset Travelers. He went secular in 1964 with the song, That's How Strong My Love Is. He recorded that for Gold Wax Records. Otis Redding heard it and covered it, stealing any chance O.V. had of having a hit with it. O.V. then went to our old friend Don Robey's Backbeat label and released a series of Deep Soul records. including this story of a man standing before the jury. On number 8 selection, 8 men, 4 women. Who have you right? The jury of love.
Was a crime. I was alone, so lonely and blue. You know why? Because 8 men and 4 women, Lord, they found me guilty of loving you. As they taking me away, you were taking, I saw you when you were taking the witness stand. You know what? I heard the lawyer when he asked you, my love, do you really love that man? It was 8 men and 4 women.
Guilty.
How could they be so blind?
Guilty.
How could they? I know they sat there and called true love a cry. Would kill me. Running tears rolled down my cheeks. I felt so sorry for you. You know why? Because in my heart I knew. Oh yes, baby, I knew that they would find you guilty too. Judge, Your Honor, and to the jury, I intend to prove beyond a shadow of doubt that we are innocent and true love is not a crime. Lord, that's the jury of love. A mean judge, a mean jury. Lord, that's the jury of love.
That was O.V. Wright and 8 Men, 4 Women. Some juries don't have any women, and the men are upset about it. 12 Angry Men is a film from 1957, starring Henry Fonda, Lee J. Cobb, Ed Begley, E.G. Marshall, Martin Balsam, Jack Klugman, and Jack Warden. It is consistently ranked in the top 30 movies of all time. Here's a scene from it, 12 Angry Men.
Everything. Every single thing that took place in that courtroom, but I mean everything, says he's guilty. What do you think, I'm an idiot or something? I bet you $5,000 I'd remember the movies I saw. I'm telling you, everything that's going on has been twisted and turned. Well, that's it. That's the whole case.
We're counting down the top 10 here on Theme Time Radio Hour. And what do you know? We got a tie at number 7.
Lucky 7.
First, from Detroit, Michigan, a two-person rhythm dynamo, Jack and Meg White, the White Stripes, with their song, Seven Nation Army. The 7 largest armies in the world are in China, India, North Korea, South Korea, Pakistan, USA, and Vietnam. But the 7 Nation Army is from Detroit and is by the White Stripes.
Back and forth through my mind behind a cigarette.
That was Jack and Meg with a message coming out of their eyes and sweat dripping out of every pore. Seven Nation Army. Here are seven other things with white stripes. A skunk, a highway, Memphis Slim's hair, a prison uniform, a candy cane, a barber pole, a zebra. Seven other things with white stripes.
Seven!
Pythagoreans call seven the perfect number. Three and four, the triangle and the square. There are seven deadly sins, seven seas, and in the Chinese culture, the seventh day of the first moon of the lunar year is known as Human's Day, to be celebrated as a universal birthday of all human beings. In a dead heat with the white stripes is the powerful and portly piano player, Aubrey Moon Mulligan. Seven nights to rock, seven nights with a different girl. Monday he's at Sister Susie's ball, and a Tuesday he's at the old dance hall. And you won't believe who he's with and where he's with him. Moon Mulligan, seven nights to rock.
I got seven nights to rock. I got seven nights to roll. Seven nights I'm gonna have a whirl. Seven nights with a different girl. Seven nights to rock. I got seven nights to roll. Monday at Sister Susie's ball, Tuesday at the old dance hall, Wednesday at the Roadhouse Inn, Thursday at the Lion's Den, Friday at the Chatterbox, Saturday and Sunday, everybody rock. Seven nights to rock, I got seven nights to roll. Seven nights I'm gonna have a whirl. Seven nights with a different girl. Seven nights to rock, I got seven nights to roll. Chicken in a different place. Seven nights to rock. Seven nights to roll. Monday, I'm gonna rock with Jane. Tuesday, it's gonna be Lorraine. Wednesday, I'm taking Nancy Lee. Thursday, it's Jenny Lou and me. Friday, I'm gonna jive with Sue. Saturday and Sunday, any chick will do. Seven nights to rock. I got seven nights to roll. Seven nights I'm gonna show my face with a different chicken in a different place. Seven nights to rock, I got seven nights to roll.
That was Moon Mulligan, a big influence on Jerry Lee Lewis, and Seven Nights to Rock. A little more of a rock and roll sound with Jane and Lorraine and Nancy Lee and Betty Lou and Sue. Any chick will do. Moon's backed up by Boyd Bennett and the Rockets. Before we move on to number six, I'm reminded of the poem by Ted Hughes about the seven sorrows, with the powerful concluding lines. And the seventh sorrow is the slow goodbye of the face with its wrinkles that looks through the window as the year packs up, like a tacky fairgrounds that came for the children. Ted Hughes, poet of deafness.
I got six, that's all there is. I got six.
We're all the way up to number six on Theme Time Radio Hour's Countdown Extravaganza. And here's Hank Thompson with one of the great beer drinking songs of all time from 1960, Capitol Recording, that reached number 10. Hank Thompson had a long career, no less than 29 top 10 hits from between 1948 and 1974. And he continued to have chart records into the 80s. Here he is, singing Six Pack to Go.
Hey, Mr. Bartender, please don't be so slow. I got time for one more round and a six pack to go. tomorrow morning, Sunday, I'm gonna be feeling low. So please, please, bartender, I want a six-pack to go. I've been a-drinking all day long, taking in the town. I've done spent my whole paycheck just a-honky-tonking round. I don't have enough to pay my rent, I ain't gonna worry though. I got time for one more round and a six-pack to go. Mr. Bartender, please don't be so slow. I got time for one more round and a six-pack to go. Tomorrow morning, Sunday, I'm gonna be feeling low. So please, please, bartender, I want a six-pack to go. I've been a-drinking all day long, taking in the town. I've done spent my whole check just a honky-tonkin' round. Well, I don't have enough to pay my rent, I ain't gonna worry though. I got time for one more round and a six-pack to go. One six-pack to go.
That was Hank Thompson and the Brazos Valley Boys singing Six-Pack to Go. Hank knew that Benjamin Franklin was no liar when he said, beer is proof that God loves us and wants us to be happy. Don't know what kind of beer Hank was drinking, but it could have been Michelob Light or Rolling Rock. Could have been Beck's or Dos Equis. Could have been drinking Irish Red or Murphy's Stout. Perhaps it was Newcastle Brown Ale, Sierra Nevada Pale Ale, or Stella Artois, or possibly Corona. Whatever he was drinking, some kind of beer that's got that single throw switch that old Hank likes. We're talking about numbers today. So grab a pencil. I want you to think of a number. Double it. Add 10 to it. Cut it in half. Subtract the original number you thought of. I know for a fact your answer is 5. Amazing.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Coming in at number 5 on our countdown show. Here's blues piano player Eddie Boyd. This song is a classic, been recorded by a number of artists, but originally done by the man who wrote it. Eddie Boyd worked 5 long years for one girl, and wait till you hear what happened.
Well, you know just what I'm talking about. If you ever been mistreated, you know just what I'm talking about. I worked 5 long years for one woman. Then she had the nerve to put me out. I got a job in a steel mill, trucking steel like a slave. 5 long years every Friday I went straight home with all my pay. You ever been mistreated? Talking about. I worked 5 long years for one woman. Then she had the nerve to put me out. I finally learned a lesson. Time ago.
shuckin' steel like a slave. From Stovall, Mississippi, that was Eddie Boyd, proving you don't need a piano tuner. Recorded for the Chess Brothers, Leonard and Philip. He died in Helsinki, Finland, a big blues town.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
One place you can hear a lot of countdowns is NASA. I was talking to Penn Jillette, who's a big rocket fan. He's been down to Florida to watch a lot of liftoffs. He told me what it was like.
You cannot beat actually hearing the voice of Mission Control out there in Florida counting down. The really important moment is right after you have ignition and liftoff, you are confronted with what I think is the most interesting number countdown thing, which is the difference between speed of light and the speed of sound. Because when the rocket starts, you see this huge explosion of smoke and belching of hellfire, and all you hear are the birds twittering. And then it goes across the 3 miles to where you are, the sound, and you get hit in the chest with the loudest pure rock and roll you've ever heard, just knocking you over.
Coming in at number 4.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
They're a country music band from California, recorded from the 30s to the 50s. Here they are, Fred, Cal, Henry, and Don. The Maddox brothers and sister Rose. I got 4 big brothers.
Get out of my way, you've had your day, cause you're just not my kind. I like to play, but not your way, you can't hand me that line. If you go too far, you're gonna see stars, just stop and look around. I got 4 big brothers, don't you go any further, you'll pick yourself off of the ground. I got 4 big brothers to look after me, I don't want you flirting with me. Don't need any help, don't need your company. They'll show you through the door, then help you out. There ain't any use for you to sit and pout. I got 4 big brothers and they'll look after me.
They'll show you through the door.
But before you go, can you let me know how soon will you be back in? I got 4 big brothers to look after me. If I need a little help,
call on me.
You sweet little man, you fill my heart with glee. If you give me a little kiss, I'll send them all away. Otherwise, you'll regret it to your dying day. I got 4 big brothers and they'll get you for me.
That was the Maddox Brothers and Sister Rose. In 1941, the Maddox Brothers were drafted to help fight World War II. Rose was left behind without work. At one point, she tried to convince Bob Wills to hire her as a singer. But old Bob wouldn't give her the time of day. She told him, "When my brothers get back, we're going to show you butt good." And true to her word, her brothers came home in 1946. The Maddox Brothers and Rose went on to become one of the most popular hillbilly bands of the late 40s and early 50s. Moving into the home stretch now on Theme Time Radio Hour, first annual countdown show. Coming in at number 3.
3, 2, 1,
out! 3, 2, 1, out!
3, 2, 1, out!
3 times 7 equals 21. This is the lovely Jewel King. She recorded for Deluxe Records. Produced by the man who wrote this song, trumpet player Dave Bartholomew. She's all grown, spending her money and having fun. Ready to do a fancy dance and have a little romance. Ain't nobody's business because she just made 21. Jewel King.
Yes, I'm 3 times 7. Just made 21.
New Orleans, the lovely Jewel King. 3 times 7 equals 21.
3, that's a magic number. It's the magic number.
Tied with Jewel King for the number 3 position is the always entertaining Ink Spots, a song written by Nelson Cogain, Sammy Marcells, and Dick Robertson. Coming in at number 3, My Echo, My Shadow, and Me. We three, all alone, living in a memory.
We three, we're all alone, living in a memory. My echo, my shadow, and me. We three, we're not a crowd, we're not even company. My echo, my shadow, and me. What good is the moonlight, the silvery moonlight that shines above? I walk with my shadow, I talk with my echo, but where is the one I love? We three will wait for you, even till eternity. My echo, my shadow, and me.
We three, we're all alone. Seem like we're living in a memory. That's my echo, my shadow, and me. We three, we ain't no crowd. Fact is, we ain't even company. That's my echo, my shadow, and me. You know, I've been wondering, what good is the moonlight? That silvery moonlight that shines way, way up above. Yeah, I walk with my shadow, I talk with my echo, but where is that gal that I love?
We three will wait for you, even till eternity. My echo, my shadow, and me.
That was the Ink Spots, We Three. The Ink Spots also performed as the Riff Brothers and the Percolating Puppies before they decided to call themselves the Ink Spots. We Three, a sad and sorrowful song about loneliness. The poet Rainier Wilkie also knew a little bit about loneliness. He says that being apart and lonely is like rain. It climbs toward evening from the ocean plains, from flat places rolling and remote. It climbs to heaven, which is its old abode. And when leaving heaven drops upon the city, it rains down on us in those twittering hours, when the streets turn their faces to the dawn, and when two bodies who have found nothing, disappointed and depressed, roll over, and when two people who despise each other have to sleep together in one bed, that is, when loneliness receives the rivers. Rene Rilke, One Lonely Poet.
Now, on with the countdown.
Well, it's only appropriate. We have two at number two, and the first one's a duet from the Motown record label in Motor City, USA. Kim Weston and Marvin Gaye, It Takes Two. It Takes Two. Marvin recorded a bunch of duets with other Motown artists, such as Mary Wells. But the most famous was Tammy Terrell. With Tammy, he recorded Ain't No Mountain High Enough, Nothing Like the Real Thing, and You're All I Need to Get By. In 1967, Tammy Terrell collapsed into Marvin Gaye's arms on stage, the first sign of the brain tumor that would kill her 3 years later. Our second selection at number two is the classic written by Vincent Heumann and Irving Caesar, T for Two, performed in this case by the blind accordion player Joe Mooney and his quintet, Oh Man, What a Boot from a Tender Shoot of Oolong.
Do you long for oolong like I long for oolong, baby? Do you long for oolong like I long for oolong, baby? Oh man, with a boot from a long tender shoot of oolong. Can you imagine me with you by my knee? T for two and two for T. Me for you and you for me alone, dear. There'll be nobody near us to see or to hear us. No relations on weekend vacations, we won't have it, no. We own a telephone. Blue the bottle, blot a dawn break, and you'll awake. Start to bake sugar cake just for me to take, so all the boys can see, dear. We will raise a family with a boy for you, a girl for me. Can't you see how happy we will be? Are you gone on Ceylon like I'm gone on Ceylon, baby? Are you gone on Ceylon like I'm gone on Ceylon, baby? Oh man, what a boot from a long tender shoot of Ceylon. Chick still on his knee. She goes for he, but is up to his eyeballs and T-balls. And there's been nobody near him to see or to hear him. No relations on weekend vacations. They've never been known to answer that telephone. Blue, the bottle, blood of dawn breaks. She awakes, still bakes those knocked out cakes. They've never been tasted, but they're not wasted. They're so pretty to see. They started to raise a family, but the kids left home at the age of three, singing oolong, too much it had oolong. And now since the kids departed, the family is right where it started, back to T for two.
Joe Mooney and his quintet, T for Two. If you're having T for Two, you might as well enjoy these types of tea. Green tea, black tea, oolong, Lorraine Bracco tea, Kim Basinger tea, Mr. Tea, Tea for Texas, Tea for Tennessee, Liberty, Fidelity and Equality.
It's number one!
We're almost to the end of our countdown show here on Theme Time Radio Hour. One of our number one selections is by the great Irish poet, the Bard of Belfast, Van Morrison, with One Irish Rover. Tell me the story now that it's over. Wrap it in glory for One Irish Rover.
Tell me the story now, darling, it's over. Wrap it. Jump out on the sea without a sail. You're gone astray. Thank you.
That was Van the Man Morrison coming in at number one with One Irish Rover. If you enjoy Irish poets, here's a couple more. Samuel Beckett, James Joyce, C.S. Lewis, Oscar Wilde, Jonathan Swift, and William Butler Yeats, who wrote the following. Wine comes in at the mouth, and love comes in at the eye. That's all we shall know for truth before we grow old and die. I lift the glass to my mouth, and I look at you, and I sigh. William Butler Yeats, A Drinking Song. Well, we got an email. This one's from Lily Rosenthal from Babylon, Long Island. Lily writes, I love the Countdown Show. I was wondering if you could play some Bob Marley. Lily, you must be a mind reader. Coming in also at number one, the immortal Bob Marley and the Wailers with their song, One Love. Bob Marley and the Wailers, talking about one love and no hiding place from the Father of Creation. Here on Theme Time Radio Hour, the countdown doesn't end at number one. We go all the way to zero.
Come in, 000-1. This job is much too big for Superman. Take over.
Gladly, Superman.
That should hold him until Inspector Henderson gets here.
Mr. Zero, you really saved the day.
Coming in at number zero on our countdown show, the Queen of New Orleans, Irma Thomas. She's singing a song written by the great songwriting team of Spooner Oldham and Dan Penn. This is a song she recorded in 1979 called Zero Willpower. Some days I got boatloads of willpower, but today, zero willpower when it comes to loving you.
I've got zero. Thank you. that you walk through. Ooh.
Thomas with Zippo Willpower, talking about being my puppet, my fool, and my clown. Zero willpower.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Well, the old clock on the wall has counted down another hour, which means we got to hit the road. But don't worry, we'll be counting down the days till we see you next week, right here on the Theme Time Radio Hour Christmas show. So long, Denver, Eleanor.
Been listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with your host Bob Dylan, produced by Eddie Gorodetsky, associate producer Sonny Webster, continuity by Eats Martin, edited by Damian Rodriguez, supervising editor Rob McCumber, the Theme Time research team Diane Lapson and Bertie Bernstein, with additional research by Lynn Sheridan, Kimberly Williams, and Robert Bauer, production assistance by Jim McBeam, special thanks to Randy Azradi, Debbie Sweeney, Coco Shinomiya, and Samson's Diner, for XM Radio, Lee Abrams. Recorded in Studio B, the Abernathy Building. Studio engineer, Tex Carbone. This has been a Greywater Park production in association with Big Red Tree. This is your announcer, Pierre Mancini, speaking. Join us again next week for Theme Time Radio Hour when the subject is Christmas.